if any discovery reports have come in while we were away.
Hey, I've been talking with the others, and I'd like to get everyone together to say goodbye. You know, to Sam. Thank you. It wouldn't be the same without you there. I'll have everything set up in a few days.
Mateo told us about your pilgrim's voyage.
You found it, didn't you? The meaning of unity. Wait, say that again? Multiple universes?
You can't possibly mean what I think you mean.
Let's take a step back. This is everything we've been building towards, and the implications are a lot to take in. Could you explain the part about multiple universes one more time for everyone?
Yes, I wouldn't mind a little more detail.
And that's why the Starborn want the artifacts so desperately. They're the keys to unlocking the infinite.
I don't even want to think about the physiological changes you'd need to travel between universes. Plus what it would do to the mind? Enlightenment? Or oblivion? Like the Hunter.
You have the opportunity to reach the closest thing to your god that might exist. And you're second-guessing it?
One doesn't approach the afterlife without some trepidation. You're right. We have to see the unity for ourselves.
I know this has been a lot for everyone to take in, but we finally have answers. Let's make the best of them.
Not to make a sharp turn in a grand tale, but I got the eye fixed up. Bruised, but still blinking. Let me know when you're ready to follow up on what it's seen. These last glimpses from the eye are from the farthest fringes of known space. Could be the only remaining pieces outside the hands of the Starborn. Aye. The blackest sea seems less of a concern when there are sharks leaping out at you. Catch a smile out there.
I will be monitoring everyone's vitals. Signs of...
Thank you. Oh, it's nice to finally be off our ship.
Research station. You speaking. What is your business here? We are a research station run by the Hadron Consortium. Our work is proprietary and confidential. Great minds advancing basic research for the future of humanity. A bunch of scientists who pool their grant funding. We haven't sent a distress signal. Nothing on the comms. No other ships in the system since our last supply drop. Look, what are you trying to pull here? Yes, I'm sure. If there was an emergency, I'd be the one sending it. Really? The high energy research lab? Alright. I don't know what's going on here, but you should talk with the director. For security, I'm going to have to ask your friend to wait out there. What's inside, stay with me, and don't make any sudden moves. I'll get the door. Welcome, Tunisina.
I'll watch things from out here, and you go do what you need to do. Just be careful.
Chief of Security. If you'll follow me, I'll show you to the director. Kaya Patel, our administrator and research director. 28 years in quantum particle physics, or so I'm told. It's beyond me. We're a small research station in the middle of nowhere. Pirates eat places like these for lunch. It is my job to make sure that we are not on the menu. We'll take the back way. Here, you can see our lovely storage area. Don't touch anything. So, Nisha is built.
What the? Easy! Easy! What the hell was that? What are you talking about? 1 minute, you're following me, and then you're just gone. Minute later, you pop in out of nowhere, looking like you were in the middle of a fight. But there's nothing here. I should have never let you inside. What is this? Some kind of stealth tick? Who are you working for? Look, I don't know what's going on. Let's get you to the director. Maybe she can figure this out. Come on, this way.
Finally, someone came. The distress signal. You picked up the distress signal, right? Rafael Aguero, chief engineer here. Well, I was. It's been so long. I'm out of food, out of water. But I made it. Wait. How did you get in here?
What? What are you talking about?
No. No, no, no. This doesn't make any sense. Unless... the accident. Maybe this is a side effect of the accident. If the probe is still feeding power to the distortion, then...
Three months ago, I was calibrating an experiment in our high-energy research lab. There was an accident. An explosion. It caused a gas leak. Sparked a fire. I was trapped in the control room. There was nothing I could do. They're all dead. An artifact? You mean... the metallic god?
Disappear! We should... wait. He's back. All right. We're on our way up. Fuse out. I was just filling in the director. Let's keep moving. If anything happens, the director's office is on the second floor, end of the hall. You can't miss it.
Thank you.
way. Director?
Thank you, Ethan.
Come in. Kaya Patel, Research Director.
And this is our Chief Scientist, Maria Hughes. Ethan said you disappeared right in front of him. Twice now? Three times?
Director, you can't be taking this seriously. Look, I don't know who you are or what you're doing here, but there has to be a rational explanation for all of this. Excuse me?
That is quite a claim. What makes you think that? Tell us about this other universe. Raphael? Raphael died in the accident. He...
Wait, burned out? The leak. Director, there was a hydrogen leak right after the accident. It was contained in a minute or two.
But if it hadn't been, it could well have caused an explosion.
Another universe, though. That's a lot to swallow. An artifact?
You mean the source of the distortion? You know something about it?
What, is this some kind of cult?
Maria, they're connected to other universes, clearly. And you have some connection with them, then. Interesting. I wonder if that's why this is only affecting you. This facility and the research level 2 kilometers beneath us were built to study a gravitational distortion. This artifact and the field it creates. 3 months ago, our chief engineer, Raphael, was calibrating an experimental probe when something went wrong.
We still don't know what happened. There was a series of explosions, and somehow, it's still running. That would make sense. That's why the field strength keeps increasing. We have a control unit for the probe. After the accident, I tried to use it to shut down the system, but the kill switch isn't responding. We could shut it off manually, but the entire research level is locked down. We can't even get down there. How? I told you the research level's locked down. We can't even use the damn elevator. What?
Clever. In this other universe, Raphael survived. He made it back from the lab, so clearly his elevator works. Take it, and you might be able to shut down the experiment.
This is crazy.
But first, we have to do something about your shifting.
We can't shut down the probe, but we might be able to adjust some of the other parameters. It's risky. We don't know what we're dealing with, but...
All right. It's worth a try.
Then it sounds like we have a plan.
Come with me. The control unit is in the fabrication lab next door. What have we gotten ourselves into?
it's you. What happened? You disappeared, and the ceiling caved in, and... I thought I'd finally lost it. What? How? Look, if you think things are bad up here, the research level is even worse. I barely made it out, and that was months ago. I don't understand any of this. If I hadn't seen you disappear with my own eyes, I wouldn't have believed it. Okay. You're my ticket out of here. We'll do this your way. We can get out through the pantry. Here's the key. I'll back you up, I guess. Look at this. It's going to take hours to clear this out. Assuming the rest of the building doesn't come down on top of us. How should I know? You're the one who keeps winking in and out of existence. I just want to get out of here. Go do whatever you're going to do. I'll see if I can clear a path to the door. They're a native species. We had an electric pulse field to keep them out. The fire took out the generators, damaged the foundation. They just keep coming. I was in the lab, working on the frequency calibration for the probe. I was walking out of the control room when it happened. I heard the tank's rupture. The alarm sound. I only had a second to react. I jumped back into the control room. The doors sealed. I was safe. From the gas, the fire, everything. But I was trapped. There was nothing I could do to stop it. If I had gone the other way, maybe I could have made it to the ventilation controls. Killed the system. Even if it killed me,
I don't know. I don't want to think about it.
I'm not sure. It might stop whatever's happening to you. It's a reasonable theory, I guess.
What? Oh, it's you. You realize you just poked into my locked office. So much for security protocols. Sure. Down the hall. Take the stairs next to the atrium. Yeah, let me get the doors for you. And done. Is there anything else you need? Yes, Kataxi. Nasty things. The original survey team ran across them. You're welcome to read the old logs if you want. Yeah, I'll unlock the terminal for you. Bigger than you'd expect. We've got a particle accelerator, whole lab complex, the high energy research lab. Real state of the art. Can't tell you what a tenth of it actually does. That's right. Has been since the accident. We can't connect to the control system to override it. The whole system's on a hair trigger. Cameras spot anyone not in the staff database. They fire off an alarm and all hell breaks loose. The Kataxi in the other universe. Uh-huh. Wow. I've got an experimental thing one of the engineers put together. But... You really don't have anything better to do? Haha, I hear you. Don't get ahead of yourself. I never agreed to anything. Sorry, I have to keep it on hand, just in case. You understand?
What, did you get lost in the hallway? All right. This is the probe control unit. Most of these controls aren't responding. I'm going to very carefully adjust the settings I can. There's no way to tell what's about to happen. Pay attention and be ready for anything. I'll begin by adjusting the energy feed of the electron beam array. We're at 93 teravolts. Calibrating to 95, 97, 100. Nothing. Let's try the other way. 91, 89. What the? Okay. It looks safe to approach. What in the world? It's a micro distortion. Flux pattern matches the distortion in the lab. The setting is just exposing it somehow. Step into the distortion, please. Nothing. No, hold on. There's a slight pattern change. Some kind of resonance. All right, stay there. Let me turn the feedback up for a moment. Calibrating to 90, 91. What happened? Are you all right? So, the lower setting causes the distortions to manifest, and the higher causes you to shift. That seems promising. Keep it on the lower setting until you want to shift, and you should be able to avoid any more accidents. I'd give you my control unit, but it looks like you already have one from the other universe. Love to take a look at that when this is all over. No, we still don't understand what we're dealing with here. If we found something that works, let's not press our luck. You may want to practice shifting just to make sure this works reliably. Closer to the distortion, conditions may be less stable, if that's possible. Right? If you can get down to the research level, you need to make your way to the high-energy research lab. Disengage the power interlocks, then pull the emergency shutdown to stop the probe. That should finally put an end to all this. Oh, and before you go, the director wanted to speak with you. It really is just down the hall.
Set? If you need supplies, I've asked Dr. Barakova to take care of you. It's the least I can do after everything we've put you through. Before you go, there is one other thing we should discuss. If this experiment is the cause of your shifting, when you shut it down, the shifting will stop. What happens then? To you and to us. Exactly. And when you shut down the experiment, the probability function will collapse. You are the outside observer in the system. Whichever reality you are in, at that moment, is what will become real. For you and your universe, at least. The question is, which will you choose? If this were a choice between my life and Raphael's, I would ask you to save him. But as the director of the station, I am responsible for the lives of my staff. 30 people. People with families, careers, futures ahead of them. In this universe. You don't have to decide now. But when the time comes, please, keep them in mind. Now, it's time you are going. With the network offline, we can't shut down the security system on the research level, so you can expect some resistance. Be careful. Ethan, unlock the elevator lobby, please.
Ma'am, research level is still locked down.
I'm aware of that.
All right. Done.
Good luck, dear. It's been a fascinating day.
Yes, what?
Tatiana Barakova, station's doctor. This is not a public medical facility, but the director has ordered me to assist you nonetheless. I can spare a few med packs. Beyond that, I am not your therapist, your psychologist, or your cosmetologist. If there's anything else you need, ask. Excuse me? Perhaps you'd care to try a dead-end medical post on some godforsaken planet in the middle of nowhere, huh? 6-year surgical residency. And I spend my days treating paper cuts and hurt feelings for a bunch of mathematicians and physicists. And now I have to deal with some spacer who thinks they're jumping between universes? Spare me.
Pardon.
Security lockdown is active. Emergency override controls are available on designated security terminals.
Thank you.
The security lockdown is active. Emergency override controls are available on designated security terminals.
Taking damage.
available on designated security terminals.
Thank you.
You're back. I wasn't sure if you were alive or... or if you were going to come back for me. I mean, not that I'm not grateful, but... why? Why not stay in that other universe? Yeah, I do. It's not much, but I scrounged up a few things you might still be able to use. You're welcome to anything else you find lying around, too. No one's going to miss it. And as for me, I owe you. You ever need an engineer, just say the word. Now, let's get off this damn rock.